this time last year, I was working very hard on a project that included me working within Python. Now, this project was included for a hackathon, meaning that this was a project that was going to be displayed in front of people. The word hackathon often gets confused with actual hacking, hacking competitions or capture the flag CTF competitions. Oftentimes, hackathons have to do with innovation, creating a product that solves a particular need or problem. Our mission statement or our prompt for this particular hackathon was develop a product that would help your community out. So that was a very broad and kind of wide product. That was a really broad and wide thing you could do. You can really develop any program that would help your community out. So I was in a team of people and I was in charge of actually developing the program, developing the product, the software behind it. So I was working in Python to create this product. I was working with a team of people, and little do you know, we completely procrastinated this project out until the very, very end. So the night before, I was working diligently within Python to get this thing to work. Now, I wasn't working at all with developing scripts or anything having a security conscience in mind. I was just trying to create a displayable project. The reason why I even give you that story and tell you that story is because, well, I was working in Python. And we often hear in security to work in Python. We hear that the programming language that you should use is Python, or the first programming language you should learn is Python. So there's a lot of talk about learning Python and understanding Python, developing scripts in Python, doing all that kinds of things. In today's video, I'm going to address why we actually use Python in security, or what I've seen, why Python is prevalent used over other programming languages. Hello everyone, my name is Grant Collins. I am a cybersecurity student and I am going to be addressing this question head on today. No fluff. Although I just had a whole bunch of fluff with that story, but I have to get some context in this. All right, let's get started. So the reasons why Python is used, I've come up with five main points. Starting with point one, which is it's very easy to learn. Python is often regarded as a great first programming language to utilize and to work with, regardless of intent. The syntax is easy to read, it's easy to understand, and it's also very much so easy for beginners to grasp the concepts, the logic behind developing these Python programs. With this being said, I don't want to tell you that programming is easy. Even in a programming language like Python, you are going to be encountering problems. It is hard. Programming is hard when you're first starting out to get the logic behind developing programs. So that's just an FYI. But usually the tendency is Python is much easier than working in a lower level language like C or C++. This being said, and it's easy to learn, it's very much so easy to implement and write and create code very quickly and easily, which in turn also creates the ability to easily debug programs. Again, something that I see beginners, including myself, struggle with is not only just understanding the logic behind programming, but then the debugging process. How do we debug? So Python is very easy to debug. And as security professionals, well, we're always looking for the easiest way to just get something done and move forward, because we have so much into our process. Python being easy to learn transitions me into my second point, which is its swiftness. Because Python is easy to learn compared to other programming languages, and I already give you the FYI, programming is not easy to learn, but compared to other programming languages, Python is easy to learn. Because it's easy to learn, it's easy to develop scripts and programs that have high functionality in a very quick time. Having the ability to create and develop scripts really speeds up the process. As security professionals, or in the security world, I'm not a security professional, but in the security world, we have so much on our plates. They have so much on their plates and they have so much they have to do. Developing programs that have high functionality with a quick time is always very handy and very helpful. Which transitions me into point number three, which is it's widely used. Points number one and two, it's being easy to learn, it's swiftness to develop programs, really attract a wide audience, not just a security audience, but just a wide audience of users, especially it being easier to learn and grasp and easier to read the syntax. That's all important for beginners, and that's why it's very widely used around the industry. Having a wide use will give you the ability to not only develop scripts easier, but will also have more documentation and just a wider audience and a bigger community of support. Having a wide use is important, which transitions into having the ability to have an extensive amount of libraries and modules. That's point four. Python has a huge number of libraries and modules that you can import, meaning you'd have to develop and write less code, and also which transitions and means that you don't have to actually write all these classes out, all these functions. They're already pre-made for you, making it quicker, making it easier to learn, making it widely used. And you see how these points very much so stack upon each other. So Python has an extensive amount of libraries that you can import and work through very, very quickly. Which transitions? How many times have I said transition? I think I've said it like tons of times. But what transitions into my fifth and final point, which is its productivity and speed. Now, that could go right with swiftness, right? It's easy and it's productive. You're not sitting there developing a whole bunch of syntax. It's productive. It's straight into the point. You write this program, it's going to do this certain task. You write this script, it's going to do this certain task. I've said task twice now. No, but it's very easy and very productive, and it's reusable. The scripts that you create, they can be reusable. It's not like you're going to develop a script and it will never be used again. You can always use it again in other situations, maybe editing a little bit of the syntax, but that's also important. So that's why Python is used compared to other programming languages. It's why it's recommended by security professionals as the first beginning programming language or scripting language when you're first learning and working through as a security or as an aspiring cybersecurity professional. Now, if you are somebody like me who doesn't really know where to go and where to learn particular scripting or Python, I recommend a course on StationX.net. StationX.net provides actually two courses, very affordable prices, and at very high productivity in terms of what you're going to be learning. One of them being the complete Python and scripting course bundle. That gives you five courses, including a Python course and four other courses, which address scripting in Bash. On top of that, we also have the complete Python for hacking and cybersecurity bundle, which includes three courses. One of those courses overlaps with the complete Python and scripting course. I recommend you go check those out if you are somebody who wants to learn scripting and understand it. So thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you found this helpful. If you did, please share, and thank you and have a good day.